Are ADHD medications safe? Are they addictive? How do they work? Hi, I'm Dr. Ari Tuckman. I'm a licensed psychologist. And today, I'll be answering some of the internet's biggest questions on ADHD treatments. Is ADHD medication safe? So there are hundreds and hundreds of studies that have shown over decades that ADHD medication is both generally safe and also pretty effective. It's important to get an accurate diagnosis by a trusted professional. If they appropriately prescribe the medication, if you take it as it has been prescribed, when you put it all together, ADHD medication can actually improve safety outcomes by helping with impulsivity and distractibility and to just make you more aware of the world around you. Are ADHD medications addictive? This is such a common question that I get. Here's my kind of snarky response. If ADHD medication is really that addictive, why do so many of my clients forget to take it? I think it's safe to say if you forget to take it, you are not addicted to it. But here's the deal, we should be concerned about substance abuse, right? Like that is a serious problem. And certainly people who are taking medication that they don't need and taking too much of it in problematic ways, clearly that's a problem that we don't want to encourage. But if you have ADHD, medication probably will help you manage your life more effectively and perhaps even reduce some of the risk for either new or ongoing substance abuse problems. So all in all, ADHD medication is not addictive when you're taking it the way that you're supposed to and have been prescribed by a professional. How does ADHD medication work? The short answer is ADHD medication affects how your brain uses dopamine, mostly right here in what's called the prefrontal cortex. But maybe more importantly is how that shows up in your life. And I sometimes say that ADHD medication closes the gap between intentions and actions. The intentions in your head, the actions of what happens out in the world. It makes it easier to focus and to pay attention on things, especially the boring stuff. Makes it easier to remember what has been said, you know, because you paid attention and heard it in the first place. It makes it easier to get yourself up and going so you're not as kind of driven by the deadline. And just in a bunch of different ways, it helps you sort of manage the symptoms of ADHD and smooths over some of those rough patches and some of that extra work that comes along with unmanaged ADHD. Does exercise help ADHD? Yes, sort of. Everybody does better after they work out. Not just that physically it's good for your body, it is good for your brain. We have more focus, we have more energy, we're better at complex problem solving after we've exercised. Exercise isn't gonna cure your ADHD, but it is gonna help you bring the best of who you are to whatever happens the rest of the day. Having ADHD might make it harder to exercise in a regular way, but it's definitely worth kind of hitting the gym or hitting the trail to get your body moving on a regular basis. Now, does exercise help your ADHD? Let us know in the comments. Can you treat ADHD without medicine? We know that medication for ADHD is effective, but whether you take it or don't take it, it's still only part of a comprehensive treatment program. You still have to do all the other good things that, frankly, most people have to do to be effective anyway. It's things like being intentional about what you're doing, writing yourself notes, using a schedule, using a to-do list, reducing the distractions and clutter that sort of pull at your attention. You don't have to take medication if you have ADHD, but if you don't take medication, you might have to work harder with these other strategies, whereas those strategies might come a little bit more easily on medication. But ultimately, it's kind of a personal decision. How are you doing in your life based on the demands that are placed upon you now? How much effort does it take? How are you doing with meeting the goals that you have? If you're doing well without medication, fine, keep going. If you feel like you're not getting to where you want to be, or you're working harder to get there than you would like to, perhaps medication might be worth considering. Again, it's a personal decision. Does caffeine help ADHD? Caffeine is not really a direct treatment of ADHD beyond what any of us might benefit from caffeine, right? We all are a bit more alert. We have a bit more energy. It's a bit easier to sort of persist at a task. We all get some benefit from caffeine. So what that means is you might find that a cup of coffee in the morning helps really kind of kickstart your brain and get your day going. But where you got to be careful is if you're drinking too much caffeine in the day, you know, to make up for all the sleep that you didn't get last night, that can make it much harder to fall asleep tonight and get a good night of sleep tonight so that you feel well rested tomorrow. Also, if you're taking stimulant medication for ADHD, you might find that a whole bunch of caffeine makes you really a lot more jittery than you want to be. So there's that consideration as well. A little bit of caffeine might be fine, but if you're overdoing your caffeine, you might want to focus more on other ways to get more sleep and other ways to get more done. Can you use supplements to treat ADHD? At this point in time, there's no supplement on the market that has enough real research to actually show that it's effective for ADHD. From the science, we can't recommend any supplements for ADHD. There is also the concern, though, that unlike prescription medication, which is extremely regulated, you know exactly what you're getting in every pill and exactly what's in the bottle, the supplement industry is very unregulated. There's a lot more variability than there should be in terms of what's in the bottle and how much are you getting, you know, within any one pill. There's also the concern that if you are spending time trying a treatment that has really not been shown to be effective, it might come at the cost of more days and weeks and months that you're not managing your ADHD more effectively with a treatment that really has been shown to be effective. So that also needs to be considered in your decision making. Do video games help with ADHD? As much as your kids would love for me to say that they do, unfortunately, the answer at this point is it doesn't seem like they do. There's certainly video games that are on the market that are being touted as benefiting various cognitive functions in terms of attention and memory and complex problem solving, maybe related to ADHD, maybe just general cognitive functioning. And the sad reality is that the research that they use to back up the claims in the advertising, it's really not there. We just don't have good evidence to show that these video games actually benefit any cognitive functioning that goes beyond whatever is happening in the video game. The goal is not to be better at the video game. The goal is that practicing this makes you better out there in the real world, in your real life, with real things that you actually care about. Maybe there's something down the road. As of yet, the answer to do video games help with ADHD, sadly, is no. Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you found this helpful, we actually have a lot more content like this on our channel, so make sure to subscribe. By doing so, you can help our mission at Understood, which is to make sure that the 70 million people with learning and thinking differences, like ADHD and dyslexia, can thrive.